So one more video when we're talking about reverse logistics and sustainability, and that's developing policies around the waste product hierarchy here. And so if you remember from what we've seen for sustainability, the ideal situation would be to reduce or eliminate the need for something non-sustainable in the first place. And if we can't do that, can we reuse it? And if we can't do that, can we remanufacture it, refurbish it? Something like that. And if not, can we recycle it and keep it all out of the landfill? So we want to give some thought to developing policies, processes, procedures, guidelines, et cetera, that are good to have regardless, so that in that sense, it's no different than anything else. It's needed in the waste hierarchy, however, for a couple of reasons. First, we want to define a good, robust process that works from the get-go for a new aspect of the supply chain. Secondly, we need to have processes for each element of the hierarchy, as each level is different with different needs and different outcomes. And lastly, there's a feeling to me that this could be like the push-pull boundaries in supply chain, and our push to move the boundary back up the supply chain towards our suppliers. And so we should be pushing efforts back up the hierarchy to eliminate the use of and need for wasteful products and components and processes, and move to eliminate them entirely would be the ultimate direction. Now, doing this is important because it's in our supply chain's future. It's being required to act this way by society and people. And if we don't do this, people aren't going to buy from us or want to do business with us. And so we're going to have no organizational future. So, at the risk of sounding dramatic, the impact is going to be survival of our business and supply chain or not, because people won't do business with us if we're not doing the reverse logistics and sustainability and circularity.